Michael, defeat to Barnsley on the, in the home opener. How would you assess the game?
I think it was very much swung by the early goal. You know, Barnsley didn't come and do anything that caught us off guard. They did exactly what we expected them to do and exactly what we'd kind of worked on. And, you know, we set up to hurt them and we'd identified areas where we thought we could. But I just thought that the early goal kind of swung the momentum in their favour. I thought we started okay. It was, you know, I think it was almost Barnsley's first foray into our half where they, you know, they nicked the goal. And then that swung the momentum in their favour in the fact that after that, whether it was the occasion and trying desperately to impress in front of 18,000 odd fans, we just looked like we rushed key moments within the game. We just needed a little bit more composure, a little bit more bravery on the ball to keep circulating, to be patient and to move the opposition a little bit more. And I just thought we rushed our play a little bit and we lost our momentum off the back of that.
Probably disappointing that second goal sort of came somewhat against the run of play, despite obviously Barnsley's dominance in the first half.
Yeah, it did. But again, I think, you know, one of the reasons why Barnsley were always going to be a threat after that first goal was because we didn't take the sting out of the game and show a little bit more composure to circulate the ball and try and find players within pockets. They are, you know, the Barnsley are a team that are happy to play on the transition. They're happy to kind of sit in, and then the moment they win it, they attack aggressively and they attack at pace. And there were times where you saw that, and they'll be a tough team for any team in the division to handle. But I do look at it. It's not frightened me. I look at it and I think we're not a million miles away from Barnsley. There are areas that we have to get better on, and we will get better. But I'm not leaving today thinking, wow, you know, we're levels apart from Barnsley. I think they will go on and be a strong force in the division. But I also think that over time, you know, we will be the same. So I'm not concerned by the result. I just thought that, as I say, that goal took the wind out of our sails a little bit, and we just lacked a little bit of composure after it.
They did manage to sort of manage our threats, didn't they, throughout Jack Payne, obviously, and Doyle particularly seemed to be sort of starved of that possession in the key areas against.
Yeah, and I think that's it. I think that if you don't show that composure to be patient and to build. We rushed play, so whenever the ball came in towards Jack and Owen, it was a little bit forced, it was a little bit rushed, you know, and it was never really clear cut for them to do what we know they're good at. The main thing that I have to say is that credit to Barnes, I think they're a very good team. As I say, they didn't do anything that we didn't expect them to do today. But there's lots for us to work on. I actually walked off the pitch very clear in the areas that kind of we fell short on a little bit today. And I think they're easily rectified, but it comes through working, being prepared to work on them. And we've got a good group of players that are honest and know that there's areas that we still need to work on. And we will do exactly that.
You mentioned the crowd, obviously. Good, fantastic support today from the City fans.
Yeah, expected nothing less. You know, there's nothing at the club that is surprising me. I'm not stood here week after week thinking, well, I didn't see that coming. They're a fantastic fan base and they got behind us from minute one to the last one. And I think, you know, on another day, had we got the penalty decision at a key time, it might have changed the complex of the game. But we didn't get it, you know. So today, last week was our day. We rode us luck at times a little bit against Shrewsbury and we got 3 points. Today, we didn't quite get them breaks and we just fell short in one or two areas. But as I say, it's the areas that I'm very clear on. I also kind of understand why that happened. I'm understanding with the players. I think that the occasion, obviously 18,000 odd fans, they were so desperate to impress, but they're a new group. They have to understand the club and the expectation of the fans, and they also have to understand that the fans will be patient with them. They will be patient, they will get behind them and they will continue to support them. And I just thought today, once we conceded, we felt the need to equalise immediately, and we don't need to do that. So patience going forward, and a little bit more understanding of just how to be a little bit more composed in games.
Four more games come up in the next couple of weeks. Starts on Tuesday night at Macclesfield. A chance, I guess, to right some of those wrongs you mentioned and just get back on the horse, but outside of the League One competition.
Yeah, definitely. And I think that, I said that to the lads before the game. Everybody needs to be ready because we have got so many games in such a short period. And it's perfect for us. It'd have been perfect off the back of a win because you can keep that momentum going. And it's perfect off the back of a defeat because you can put it right straight away. So we will do that. We will dust ourselves down over the course of the weekend. We'll have a chat as a coaching staff as to how we see best going forward into the next few games. And off the back of that, we'll pick a team, and whichever team goes out against Macclesfield, we'll be going out to win the football game.